Today on Podcast Rock City, we're going to have a fist fight about who's more beautiful, Mira Sorvino or Sonny who?
Lauren.
Holly. Today on that's not all we're going to talk about. We got some big news for you guys right here on Podcast Rock City Live.
Podcast Rock City.
What's up, everybody? Joe here from Podcast Rock City, and with me this week is Sonny Hollywood Pooney.
What's up, peeps? I'm supporting Click Tease here with my Eric Carr shirt. You like that?
Oh, that's really nice.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, that's nice. And back from his hiatus doing God knows what, getting married again. Mr. Joey Quesada.
Yo! What's up? Just to clarify, getting married again, but to the same woman.
Yes.
Yes.
That woman had a way out and she didn't take it. Now it's on her.
That's the most evil thing I have ever heard Sonny say. Oh, boy. Not really. And right there is the goddess of thunder herself, Lee Westy. How you doing, Lee?
What's up? Hi, everybody.
It's like, I'm still waiting for emails where they go, that somebody's going to go, why aren't you introducing the lady first? And I'm going to go, because she wouldn't want that.
Because I'm one of the guys.
Yeah, that's right. I hope you guys are all doing well. Thank you for joining us on this beautiful Sunday. And a lot has happened over the last few days. You're going to hear us talk about some controversial subjects, and we're going to really get into it. I want to thank you guys for being here and listening to the last show. Don't forget, if you'd like to get a Podcast Rock City t-shirt, you could go to clicktees.com and you can even get a shirt just like Sonny's right there. They have them as well. Eric Carb shirts. I don't have my coffee mug here, but I got a coffee mug and a t-shirt, and Podcast Rock City shirts are there. Everyone that you buy kicks us back a little money and helps us pay for this shindig. Right there on the screen, you can see Chris Sinzak says, "Hola, fellas." That was a Bay City Psychos song at the beginning. Let's see. We've got to get to it because we got a lot to talk about. So let's go ahead and get to the. I'm behind. I'm sorry. What the news?
Podcast Rock City News.
All right, so one of the very few times you're ever going to hear me talk about another show on my show, I'm going to mention, here's the truth. I only like half of the cast of this show. I'm not going to tell you which one.
I love the
show. This show?
No. The show that I'm about to talk about. I want them to worry about who I love. And I'm just kidding. No, I'm not.
And I was going to say, how are you going to do half? Like you like one and don't like the other, basically?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's not true. I like them both, but I'm playing the bad guy. It's right. And by playing the bad guy, I'm also going to say this. Okay. Ever. Okay, so here's the thing. By playing the bad guy right now, I'm also going to do this. Happy birthday, Mike Brandvold. Let's see.
Whoa. First of all, I do love... It's so funny you said that because I was actually going to bring that up. I love the fact right away off the bat, I don't know what the hell's... Listen, I'm obviously... I love this show. I'm on this show all the time. I'm not one of these KISS podcaster guys. The old rules go out the window. No more... Coke can't talk about Pepsi. No more of that garbage.
Right.
We can mention other shows. It's okay. Do you know why? Because we all have the same audience. Everyone has the same audience.
No,
the
it's
guys
true.
Who listen to Shout It Out Loud Cast, listen to us. The guys who listen to Three Sides of the Coin, listen to us. We love all the shows. Joe doesn't like any of them. I love all the shows. I actually listen. I listen to all of them. I love all of them. I hate Tom and Zeus. They're two morons, but I do like listening to their show. Unfortunately, I listened to last week's show with my son in the car, and Zeus said the F-bomb 17 times before 1 minute was up. I had to shut it off.
I'm going to be honest. I like every show except that fucking FAQ show. I cannot listen to that show. No, they know I'm kidding right there. They know I'm joking. Those guys are awesome.
No, but it's great that you said it, Joe. There's no reason why we can't talk about other shows.
Know,
come on.
I know. And if there was one thing that we that Joey and I did a lot during Creatures Fest is we hung out with Lisa from that show.
She's my buddy.
She's your buddy, yes. Okay, so look, I'm already starting with controversy. All right, so we're at the news. On Shout It Out Loudcast, they had... Now, I haven't heard the show. I know Sonny did. So, Sonny, break it down. This has to do with the videos that have been coming out, correct?
Yeah, and I think his name is Roy Dam.
Roy Dam.
We'll just call him Roy. So he's been on the show a couple of times. A little bit of a crazy guy, right? He's in the, you know, all of us are probably a little crazy. He's got a big personality, so his crazy comes out a little bit different. But, you know, he's been involved in the Kiss world, you know, whether it's with bootlegs or live stuff, blah, blah, blah. And I think they brought him, I know that they brought him on a second time because they wanted to straight up ask him if he was Sam Loomis, which he denied. And then, you know, they asked him, you know, who do you think it can be? And he had some interesting words to say, I thought.
Yeah, so basically, he didn't say any names, but he described a few people. Now, this is what I'm going to tell you. When you get done listening to this show, go over and listen to the Shout It Out Loudcast show. If you have never listened to it, today is your opportunity. Go listen to Shout It Out Loudcast. Not with your kid in the car.
No, definitely not.
Yeah, that would be a bad idea.
Yes. Okay. So if you've never, and I'm assuming you have heard of the show, and I'm assuming you have listened to it because there's only so many Kiss fans to go around. But if you have never heard of them, go listen to it. He's going to describe some people. You may know of them. You may not know of them. And, you know, we'll go from there.
And for the non-Kiss freaks that might be listening, which I can't imagine why the hell you'd be listening to this if you're not a Kiss freak. But the long story short, there's been these Kiss bootleg leaks coming out online anonymously from a guy calling himself Sam Loomis. And it's been a big controversy in the Kiss world. These are bootlegs that no one's ever seen before. Unreleased footage that supposedly got stolen from someone else. And this guy, Sam, is getting back at them and putting them on the internet. So there's a big controversy. Who is Sam Loomis? Why is he doing this? So that's kind of the big talk in the Kiss world right now.
Right. And, you know, Joey hasn't been here. We've talked about it a few weeks in a row, of course. Joey, you have talked with us because, of course, in our text messages, you're able to keep up with everything that's going on there. But you've been on the road and you've been doing all kinds of stuff. You've watched all the videos?
Yeah, I mean, I'm a big bootleg guy. I have a million bootlegs myself. But I love audio quality first. Some of them, I watched every one of them. Some of them I can't get through, even though, you know, it's cool to see for the first time. I need to have good audio quality. I don't care if it's from 1974 and I've never seen it before. If it sounds like horse shit, I don't want to watch it. I don't care if I see Gene in a costume I've never seen before, if I can't hear what they're singing. You know what I mean? Even the Asylum footage, which I love. You know, I saw the Asylum tour 3 times live, and I love that era of Kiss. It was hard for me to get through, even though it was fun watching them prance around in those costumes. I couldn't hear the songs well enough. I just didn't like it. But it was cool to see some of that stuff.
Yeah, I'm in the same boat because when the sounds, I can't get through.
Me too.
Right. One of the things that bothered me is, and I think that it has something to do with my obsessive compulsiveness, is that I didn't get full songs in that Asylum stuff.
Yeah.
It was just, and there were a lot of them that had just the, so as soon as I started, get your hand in my, take me. Anyway, you know, I was just like, wow, jumping from one, you know, it's from one to another, and I couldn't take it. But so I watched them all because it was, you know, it's one of those things. If I haven't seen it, I want to be able to say I've seen it. And the Atlanta, the peaches in Atlanta, that video was pretty amazing. But the thing now here is, I mean, you know, now it seems like now the search is it. Before it was, who cares who Sam Loomis is? Keep putting out videos. Now it seems like you stop putting out videos. Who did this?
Right.
And
the controversy is almost more fun than the videos. I got to tell you, I, you know, as much as I love the videos, the controversy and the Kiss fans going nuts is to me way more entertaining. Much like when we talked about Creatures Fest, I would have much rather seen the Vinnie Vincent performance that I got rather than see a perfect performance. Because again, I want to see chaos. I love that stuff, and that's what we're witnessing right now in the Kiss world. It's pure chaos. What's going on? And it's great.
Yeah,
it must be a pleasure to be married to you again. I love chaos. Anything that sets it off.
Well, one of the things that about this whole thing that was awesome was it perked us all up again as far as being a Kiss fan. Just think about a week before all this footage came out, the only footage we had was Paul lip syncing and messing up his lip sync. It bummed everybody out, man. If you're a real Kiss fan, you love the band unconditionally. That's fine. If you're a real Kiss fan, you don't have to love the band unconditionally. I that's how I feel. You're a real Kiss fan. You love the music. That's the first thing. And, you know, I understand. And you could be bitchy if you want about whatever's happening. If you don't like the fact that Paul's getting because he's not lip syncing every song. I know this because when I see him live, there's still parts where it's crappy. And he's not going to fake crappy, you know? So, anyway, so, but, yeah.
Hold on, we haven't talked about this theory. I just thought of something. You ever see the movie Wag the Dog?
No.
They make up a story because there's something happening in the government, and they make up this war to shut that thing down, right? So maybe it's Paul or Sam Loomis.
Oh,
to distract,
because nobody's talked about lip syncing for the last 3 weeks.
That is a new one.
You know, the title of the show today is Paul Stanley wagging the doll. The doll.
Paul Stanley is Sam Loomis, according to Pooney.
That's the title of the show today. We're going to get a million views.
But it was great on this other show, which I just actually finished listening to today. You know, they debunked a couple of theories that, you know, there's names, some names named. I'm sure people in the Kiss community know who they were. But the whole controversy to me is it's funny to an extent, because there's so many different things to look at during this whole fiasco. You know, people are screaming, you know, if this person who owned these videos or says that he owns the videos, you know, owning one of these videos is a very touchy subject, because there's so many different ways to own one of these videos. You could own the video rights to it, meaning the likeness rights. You could own the publishing to the music. You could own the concert performance in that video. So there's a lot of different aspects of owning one of these videos. For instance, like the Kite Fest thing, whoever filmed that in the audience owned the visual properties of that show, right, of that movie, but they don't own the Kiss concert in that and the music in it. So the person, whoever owned, or, you know, I'll say owned in quotes every time, says that they own these unreleased videos and they're being shared without them, you know, liking it or giving permission. To me, it's all a farce, because I don't know if anyone legally owns full rights to any of these videos. That's my take. I really don't know.
Right. And
but Joey, you're talking about the person that's in the audience taping the Kite Fest.
Yeah.
He owns an illegal piece of merchandise.
Of course.
This is all illegal, right?
Well, not all of it. Not all of it. Because something like Largo. So let's say, for instance, Largo, right? So the in-house video crew at Largo, because obviously we get a lot of Largo tapes from Virginia. Largo's Virginia, I believe, right? So it's because there is an in-house video.
Maryland?
I thought it was Florida.
I thought it was Maryland. I don't know.
Maryland, yes. Largo, Maryland. Right. Yeah. So the in-house video crew videoed those concerts, which Kiss might have or might have not signed off on that Largo owns the visual rights to those recordings. Doesn't mean they own Kiss's performance in those recordings. Doesn't mean they own the publishing to those songs in those performances. So the Largo video company, who let's just call them Largo Entertainment, whoever the hell it is, technically does own that footage. And they could sell that to somebody, you know, like a Kurt Gooch. And Kurt Gooch could buy that and then license out the video likeness of that. Because Kiss wouldn't own it. But Kiss would own the music and the performance in that video. So someone like Gooch could buy it, which is what he does, I think, for a living. He owns his own company, licensing company. He would buy a likeness of that Largo video, and then he would license it out to maybe Kiss, and they would sync up, or they would let their songs be played in whatever compilation they put out. But he wouldn't own it fully enough to distribute it, because there's still Kiss music in that, which he doesn't own.
Right.
So that's
now,
why all these legality things come into play.
Right. Now, here's the thing that I want to also bring up. If you remember watching the documentary, I don't believe that when they showed footage that we had never seen in that documentary, and I'm pointing at my TV like a moron, I don't believe there was any of the music or the sound.
I don't remember. You're right. And that could be why.
And yeah, because they don't own the... They showed the video of Paul and Gene rocking out at Kitefest, but there was no sound or music to that. So one of the things that cracked me up about when you and I were talking, Joey, was you said, it's amazing that the bootleggers are complaining that the bootleggers are bootlegging bootlegs.
It's baffling to me because, again, even if someone like, let's just, again, the accusations going around are, Kurt Gooch or someone had these unforeseen videos, blah, 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 and he either sold them...
Allegedly
sold them to certain parties for a lot of money, telling these parties these were the only copies, right? Or Kurt Gooch, as far as what on Shout It Out Loudcast came about today with Roy Dam, saying he never sold any of these. So if that's true, then that means Kurt either lent them to someone or showed them to someone and they copied his footage, right? Because if he only is the only person to own some of these, how did Sam Loomis get these videos, right? So even if Kurt Gooch said, hey, blah, 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 Mr. Sonny Pooney, I'm going to send you a copy of this, but do me a favor, please don't show anyone this footage. Huh. He's got to be an idiot because anyone with, you know, Sonny Pooney's character is going to immediately go to the internet and distribute it. And that's what I would do too. And the Kiss collectors out there screaming, we're the only ones that have this because we paid for it, blah, blah, blah. It's a joke. Give me a break. Stop. You don't fully own these rights to almost, I can't imagine any of this. So it's all bootlegging at the end of the day.
Right. And the thing is that according to the videos that were put out, you know, actually, I think what we saw was a post from this Sam Loomis person, right, Sonny? Where basically it said, this is happening because so-and-so wouldn't stop selling these videos after saying they'd only sold one or something like that.
Right.
I don't remember the name in there, but I want to say it was Gooch. Now, this is all alleged because the truth
right.
is...
All the names are irrelevant, right.
It doesn't really matter because the truth is, none of this could be true. It might not be any of those people. It could just be somebody going, I've got all these things and I'm going to make an excuse to put them out. You know, for all we know, this Gooch guy sitting at home going, I didn't do anything. This
right.
was stolen or, you know, this is the truth. That's why you say allegedly, because who the hell knows the truth? I do know this though. Sonny is Sam Loomis.
My question is, would you believe anybody now? Anybody comes up and says they're Sam Loomis, would you believe them now?
And it honestly doesn't matter. Who cares? To me, The way I look at it is, who cares who Sam Loomis is? Whoever you are, and all these buyer circles who have these unreleased videos that they're afraid that more of them are going to come out through the Sam Loomis, shut up. Just bring, put them out, either put them out on YouTube or whatever. Or if you're going to license them to Kiss and that's what you're trying to do, then by all means, guys, I get it. If you own a property that Kiss doesn't own and you're literally trying to license it to Kiss, I get it. But if you're just because you want to be special and own a video no one else has, I think it's just a joke at the end of the day. It really is. What are you going to die with? The die with the Kite Fest video under your pillow? Give me a break.
Yeah. Lee, what do you think?
I'm just taking it in. This is your guys' deal. I love the drama of the Sam Loomis thing. I think it's hilarious. I'm enjoying the videos. I know you guys like to have the sound on there and everything, but I just love watching them, even if the sound sucks. I just like seeing what they looked like back then, and just because that was, I love the 70s Kiss, so yeah, I'm enjoying it.
Now you got to sit back now to stir the pot a little bit, even more. Your YouTube, this Sam Loomis guy, your YouTube page got shut down. Start another one.
Right. Oh, yeah. Exactly. Another profile on Facebook.
Yeah. Another horror movie psychologist. And, you know, there you go. And start putting, because I believe what I read was what we had seen was the tip of the iceberg.
Right.
So come on, let's go. Let's get to it.
Right. You can keep doing it if you want to. Just keep jumping.
Mm-hmm. And for anyone who thinks, you know, everyone's like, oh my God, the channel got removed. Guys, please.
Make another one.
It's all over the, if you search these videos on YouTube, there are 30 different channels that have all those videos up right now. They're all still there. Once they're on YouTube, they're everywhere.
They're never going away. And if you want to buy them with a nice case, you just go on eBay. They're already there.
Yeah. Or Facebook.
You're on eBay?
There are Facebook groups. They have the whole Sam Loomis collection for sale. Now, again, this is the legality of things. Obviously, I get it. That's illegal. Kiss is going to lose money in the long run. And the only people who should be pissed really are Kiss. Because if they want to eventually get these rights, or if you own a full ownership of one of these videos, which, again, please email me directly and tell me how you own full ownerships when there's music licensing in it. And publishing licensing, you don't. I know you don't. It's impossible. So if you think you own full rights to any one of these videos, unless it has no audio, of course, if you have full licensing rights to just the visual aspect, I get it. Because again, like I said, maybe you want to license it to Kiss, so on and so forth. But my thing is, if you did own that, and this guy, Sam Loomis, has it, then you're a fool because you obviously gave it to someone and that person gave it to someone and so on and so forth. This wasn't, your computer wasn't lost or a hard drive stolen where, you know, someone obtained these illegally. You freely must have given these out to people. And if you think Kiss fans are not going to distribute them, you're nuts.
Yeah. Well, that's enough said about that. And if you are Sam Loomis and you want to send us some videos, you can send them to podcastrockcity1.
That's the number one. You better believe
it. @gmail.com. And podcast RockCity1, that's the number one @gmail.com. Now, before we go on to our topic of the week, all you guys that are watching right now, there's 40 of you watching. This is what I want you to do. Right under the video, click the thumbs up. Or if you're on YouTube, click the heart or whatever they have. A thumbs up. I don't know what they have. But go ahead and click that right now. Ready? Go. And that helps our video move to the forefront. And people get to see our video and listen to us and yell at Sonny for his picks. And today's topic of the week, you're going to find out in three. Oh, I'm not going to count. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3.
Podcast Rock City. Topic of the week.
It's amazing how 9 seconds of video can get caught by a computer every week that I play. I play it and they go, hey, and I'm like, dude, nobody's even watching. All right. OK, so Topic of the week. We have been doing a series where we did all the Ace songs we would like on a perfect Ace Alive album. We did Gene last week, and we have Paul this week. And there's four of us on here, so we're going to go ahead and zap these out for you. You pick 12 songs you would like to hear if you got to pick the set list for a Paul Stanley live album, solo album. Now, I know that there's a video out there from when he played, did his Live to Win tour, but I didn't even look at that because I was afraid that it was going to mess with me. So, Joey, why don't you, have you finished your list? Are you still working?
Yes,
on it?
I finished it, but this, I gotta tell you, this was very hard.
It's hard.
This was not easy to do, especially when you had only 3 minutes to do it. I mean, this was,
technically you had 4.5 weeks. What the hell have you been doing?
I love my list, but I mean, I know I forgot a million things, but I tried to, this is what I would want to hear off the top of my head.
Okay. So hit us with your first song.
I mean, there's so many good openers for Paul, but I'm an Eric Carr guy. I got to go Creatures of the Night to open it.
That's a good song. You can't miss with that one, especially if you have a good drummer, you know, like the guy that's in Quarantine.
Damn. That's good. That was below the belt right
now. No,
there.
He's right. Kent is a beautiful, beautiful man. And so is Joe
I've never hit Joey like that.
You can't even say it with a straight face.
And Charlie, PJ, and as you know, PJ and Chris of Jericho are dead to me.
I will tell you this. This is important for you to know, Joey. So far, 2 weekends in a row, I believe Sonny has had you as the drummer in both of these bands.
Well, yes. Wait, do we have to pick a band too?
No, you don't have to. He did. And he was like, Quesada is playing drums for Ace Frehley. Quesada.
Sonny is extra when it comes to this.
Yes. Okay, Lee. Lee, your first song.
My band is always the original four. So my first song, I'm opening with King of the Nighttime World, of course.
That's cool. A great song, too. Thank See, there's you. Really no, unless somebody says, you know, Bang Bang You.
Whoa. Hold on a second.
You're gonna be fine. You know, anything for my baby, I shut the system down. Okay, go ahead, Sonny.
All right, so I named my CD, of course.
So extra.
Right? It's called Makeup Free Live. It's easy.
Okay? Makeup Free, I like that.
Okay.
And what he decided to do was he pulled a Vinny. He's not gonna end up like Vinny. But he's not. He hasn't told anybody who's in his band, and he's gonna announce it during the show. So if you can't pick out who all the people are, he's gonna let you know after the fourth song. So like, there's just people on stage. It's like, all right, well, I guess this is Paul's band. You're trying to figure out like, is that who I think it is? That kind of thing. But dude, you gotta open with "I've Had Enough." There's too many cool songs to open with. "I've Had Enough" is one of them.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, I hate your guts, Sonny, but that's a good pick.
I'm going to tell you this. So far, there's three different songs here, okay? And I'm about to make it four because...
Exciter.
Damn. No, I'm kidding. I say that the best song to open a Kiss show with is "I Stole Your Love." I love that one. It's like stomping on the gas pedal and just going. So my first pick is "I Stole Your Love." Joey?
Yeah, my second song was actually Sonny's first song, "I've Had Enough."
Yep, good song.
Just a powerhouse song. Again, that Animalize album to me is especially the – I mean, obviously Gene is okay there too, but – The Paul Animalize songs are so underrated, production-wise, vocally. Everything about those songs are fantastic.
Yeah, absolutely. Lee?
Let's see. My second one is off the 78 solo album, which I know Sonny can't stand.
No, he loves Paul's solo album.
Oh, you love Paul's?
I love Paul.
Whose didn't you like?
Peters and Gene's.
Oh, okay. So I picked Wouldn't You Like to Know Me for my second one.
Great song. Sonny, number two.
Yeah, one of the things I tried to do is I tried to stay away from the 89 tour and the 2006 tour set list. It's tough to do because he did some great songs on that, but I tried to stay away. So I went from I've Had Enough to Love in Chains. I love Paul's solo album. I think it's the best solo album.
So good. Before, so. Yeah, it is.
Yeah, I agree. Let's see. My second song is Under the Gun.
Great stuff.
Yeah, yeah. I sat in my bed today all day long because I had nothing to do and just listen. And I was like, we could have picked 20 songs and I would have had trouble with this because it's just, there's so many good Paul songs. Mm-hmm. So I went with, what did I say I went with?
Under the Gun.
Oh, Under the Gun. My bad. I'm not wearing my glasses. I can't see. Okay. Yeah. Under the Gun. Joey.
Did you just say I didn't wear my glasses? Again? I can't remember.
Yeah, I think he did.
No, I can't.
It's a combo. It's a combo.
I don't have my glasses on. I can't hear what you're saying.
Listen, right? This is what I can tell you. It's not fun to make people that are cognitively messed up. Thank you. I don't know that I am. I'm just kidding. Joey, number three.
So for my number three, I go back and forth, but this is probably my favorite 80s Paul song, Who Wants to Be Lonely? It's, again, it's such an underrated track. They never did it live, really. It's fun video, just a perfect, perfect song.
It really is. Sunny, yes. Are you writing all these down?
Yes, I always do.
I know you were. I forgot. Oh. When we're all done, when we're done with all these, after the Peter Chris next week, which we'll put them all out and we'll let everybody vote on whose is the best.
Because when we do Peter Chris next week, it'll be an EP. Oh, it'll be a maxi single.
Come on now.
Listen, poor Lee loves these guys so much.
I love them so much.
She's always like, oh, man, why you got to do that?
Why you got to do that to Peter?
Yes. Did you? I say you guys, Lee. Did you post the picture of Peter Chris today with Joe Perry?
I didn't post it. Someone sent it to me.
And you said, did you give it to us on the text messages?
Yes. Yeah.
If you guys have not seen this, I challenge anybody to tell me that Peter looks older than Joe Perry. Joe Perry looks 5 years at least older than Peter Chris. Okay.
Peter looks great in that picture too. He's got the little gray coming through now. I think he's got to go gray, almost like what Carmine did. Carmine, a piece.
Let it go.
Yeah, I love it.
Same Peter with looks... Joe Perry needs it with that hair coloring. Like, who's doing his hair color? It's bad. He needs to fix that.
Joe Perry is in like Keith Richards territory now. He's no, he's struggling. He's struggling to stay alive.
Aww.
I mean, looking, not health-wise. Health-wise, he's okay. Right. I'm just saying looking. Right. I'm just saying looking. He still looks better than Pooney. Just saying.
Oh, jeez. I didn't know Joe Perry Project was playing shows right now.
Yeah, he's doing some one-offs, I think.
Cool.
Who's next?
Lee.
Lee.
Oh, third song?
Tres, yes.
All American Man, of course.
Nice.
Dang. That's a good one. I didn't even put that one on my list. And it was just so hard. It really is now. I'm upset about it. Hey, good night, everybody. Okay. Sonny.
So Paul hasn't said much. You know, there's got to be a little rap here and there. He's not going to do a lot of rapping today. Right? So he just says, if anybody remembers Dress to Kill, I'm still getting some room service.
Nice.
Dude, I love it. I hate that you never hear that song anywhere. Like, it's just buried. It's just so buried.
Mm-hmm. See, again, that's a song from that era. How did that not become one of the staples? It's so funny. You know, you look back and you say, how did these songs become the Kiss staples? Why is Cold Gin better than Room Service? Or why, you know what I mean? It's Room Service is one of the hookiest songs they've ever written.
Yeah. No, it is. Number three for me is going to be Take Me. I love that song. I wish they were playing it live. I mean, amongst 300 other songs I'd like to hear. But look, people are like, thank you for putting your list here. That's awesome.
Nice.
Loving, loving off grid. Love that. That's awesome. I'll leave that up for a second so everybody can take a look at it. Yeah. So my third song is Take Me. Joey.
Yeah. So I'm not going, I was originally going to go all oddballs because I wanted to hear all these songs that I've never heard before, but I got to throw a couple staples in. This is kind of an old school Kiss staple. Come On and Love Me. Probably my favorite Paul song from the first three records. Always loved it. Always thought it was a little underrated too. It doesn't get its just due in the later years.
Absolutely. It definitely is one of those songs that needs to be in the set list, I think.
Agreed.
Lee?
What are we on, four?
Yes.
My fourth one is an old one that I always loved. Love Her All I Can. I just thought it was always so groovy. I always loved that one.
Yep. You see, the cool thing about this is you, if you take all the songs that we pick and just take out all the doubles, you have a great Paul Stanley set list or playlist for your, I don't know, what are the kids using today? iPods or whatever?
iPod. No, they're not.
I'm kidding. I know it's not an iPod. But, all these songs are great, you know. Sonny?
All right, so before we get to the fourth song, Paul's got to introduce the band, right? Because now people are trying to figure out, like, they can kind of tell who it is, but they can't really. So he goes, all right, let me introduce the band. So on drums, we needed a drummer. This guy showed up, and he wouldn't leave. So, ladies and gentlemen, that's Joey Quesada there. He doesn't say much, and whenever he talks, we tell him, shut the hell up. And he just shuts up, and that's why he gets to stay.
I'll take it.
And Joey starts saying something, and Paul says, shut up. And Joey shuts up. That's how it goes.
Okay.
So then Paul moves over.
Thumbs up, Paul.
So Paul moves over to the bass. He goes, since I'm old, but I still look good, we had to get a bass player that also looks good. So ladies and gentlemen, this is Zach Throne. Right? Because that dude, that cutoff shirt, homie still looks pretty good for how old he is. It was all guys. It was all guys.
Oh, I see how it
I'm
is.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
Oh, my God.
Whatever.
Oh, the controversy. Now we're going to get letters.
Yeah, right? So then he goes to the keyboard player. So he says, it's hard to find a keyboard player that's equally as good on guitar.
But I don't play keyboard.
I went with somebody.
Dang it.
So I went with somebody that has toured with me before, and he introduces Paul Taylor. So he's got Paul Taylor.
Cool. That dude's in Winger, right?
Yeah.
He toured.
So then he gets
Paul
to the guitar player. Huh?
He toured with Paul?
Yeah, Winger. Winger did.
Oh, yeah, right. I thought you meant with Paul.
So then he gets to the guitar player, and everybody thinks they got figured out, right? But so Paul says something like, can't even explain the guy's talent. He's Ace, Vinny, Bruce, Tommy, all into one. And the reason it sounds so good is, ladies and gentlemen, that is John 5.
Oh, yeah.
So he's got a pretty good band together.
Pretty good.
That are all Kiss fans, obviously, right? And then they go into All American Man.
Ah,
not bad.
He said it. Beautiful. He said a pretty good band, and I was waiting for the zing on Joey, and it didn't come. So that's nice. Okay, so that's number four, right? My number four is going to be Magic Touch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So these are all songs. I mean, I don't know. One of the things that I've noticed is I seem to not know the non-makeup as well as I know the makeup. I always seem to go to the makeup stuff first. I don't know why. So I have to force myself to grab Crazy Nights or force myself to listen to Lick It Up, even though they're great albums. Mm-hmm. I put it on, I love it. But for some reason, I think what I like is I can put on a live and hear songs from three different records, and I'm happy with that as opposed to just putting, unless I'm doing, I don't know. I'm just strange like that. But Magic Touch is one of those songs that I really don't listen to that album, even that album, too much. That's my number four. Joey?
My number five we're up to, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
C. I got to go again off Creatures, a song no one ever talks about, Danger. always such a great song. What a great groove by Eric. Paul's, you know, obviously Creatures and Lick It Up are sister albums, but, you know, even going through this, you can't deny the songs on Creatures. Even the Paul songs are just superior. I love Lick It Up, but Creatures of the Night album is incredible. I got to go with Danger number 5.
Awesome. Lee.
Yeah, Joe, I have the same issue because you notice I always pick makeup songs because that's what's ingrained in me. It's just, I mean, I love the 80s stuff too, but if I'm picking songs, they're usually makeup era.
Right.
So my 5th one is Flaming Youth because I love Destroyer so much. So.
Yeah.
Awesome. Sonny?
I'm the exact opposite. I go with the 80s songs usually first.
Right? Yeah, but you came You came in the 80s, correct?
Yeah, yeah. And I know those albums better. Like, I have a hell of a time trying to name the 10 songs on Hotter Than Hell. Like, I can't always remember them. But damn it, I can always remember Crazy Nights. Like, I don't know why.
Wow.
Right? And I think it's just all kind of when you came into.
Sure.
I said that because I'm going with Heart of Chrome next. Because you got to have good 70s, 80s mix. And the stuff in the 80s, and I think Joey would agree with me, it's peppier, right? It gets the crowd going. If you kind of stay away from the ballads, those are pretty moving songs.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Awesome. So, yeah, Heart of Chrome.
No, that was your number 5. My number 5 is King of the Mountain. Mountain. That song is just balls to the wall. Like balls to the wall. It starts with a kick-ass drum, and I love the fact that I've had the opportunity to see that song live, not with Kiss, but with I think Bruce's band played it on the cruise, and that was really awesome. And it didn't matter that it wasn't Paul singing it; it was just a great song to hear. And So my number 5 is King of the Mountain.
Nice,
nicely done,
Joey.
Yeah, so for me, number 6, Sonny mentioned the album Crazy Nights. Yeah, I'm a big 80s Kiss mark, too. As much as I love 70s Kiss, I forget where it was. Someone asked me recently, I think I posted something on Instagram, asked me a question. And someone asked me, and it's the first time someone ever asked me this, would I pick 70s or 80s Kiss? And my first instinct would be, of course, 70s Kiss. And then I'm like, you know what? I don't think so. If I'd have to choose from 74 through 79, and then take 80 or even start at Creatures. If you want to give me from Creatures on, but even if you want to take 80s Kiss, calling it 1980, starting with Unmasked, I would take 80s Kiss any day of the week. Just for pure songs alone. Just the songs, the quality of the songs are incredible. Removing the image and the hype and the you know, the movies and the makeup and all that stuff. The songs from the 80s Kiss era are they're just to me better songs. And this is a song that gets completely shit on every time I mention it. I'm a big mark for the Crazy Nights record, like Pony, and I love My Way. Love it.
Oh, I like that song though.
Love
I do.
That song. Yeah. It's just the message. I know the production and the keyboard's heavy, but I, as a musician, I can remove myself sometimes from that stuff. I hear the song always first. It's just a great song, great message, incredible vocal by Paul.
Yeah, no, it really is. Lee.
My 6th song is Making Love. I always loved that one.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, wow. I always seem to put, I know they came out separately, years apart, but Making Love and Come On and Love Me, I don't know why, they kind of remind me of each other for some reason. But yeah, I really love that song. And let's see, Sonny, you're next. 6.
All right. So this is the curveball in my set. So Paul gets on the mic after Heart of Chrome and he says, all right, you know what? Kiss fans are the best fans in the world, but you guys are crazy because this Sam Loomis guy is really getting on my nerves. So I'm going to do something that people think is out there, but I'm telling you, even the Sam Loomises of the world don't have this. So he can't remember exactly what timing it was, but he says 82, 83, the guitarist in our band wrote this song. He wanted me to try it. I didn't really want to try it. So this is the first time we're ever going to do it live. Zach, my buddy here on bass, is going to do the easy part, and they go into Back on the Streets.
Oh, boy. Killer.
Wow. Wow.
And you get the first ever live Back on the Streets with Zach and Paul doing the vocal.
Great. I hate you, Pooney.
Wow.
God damn it.
That's what happens when you have 4.5 weeks to do it, and you're doing it 4.5 minutes for the show.
Pooney's up in the middle of the night. I could see him. I know how to get Joey. Ready? Back on the Streets. And I could see him in the middle of the night, waking up 4 a.m, running to his stupid pen and paper outside, putting it in. This will get him.
My number 6 is going to be I'll Fight Hell to Hold You.
Yeah.
Man, I love Paul's voice in that. I mean, he is singing to somebody. I don't know who he wrote that song to, but he's letting them know with his vocal that he cares about them at least, I guess. It's like, because every song Paul writes is personal, whether it's vindictive or whether it's, yeah. You know, he's like Prince, you know, every song has meaning and every song is personal. There are no songs where he's just sitting around going, I think I'll write a song about a canoe today. And then he writes a song about a canoe. That's not Paul, you know.
So who's Tito then?
Oh,
who's Tito?
Maybe Gene's Tito.
Yeah, who's Tito?
I don't know. Maybe, yeah, Gene.
Tito
Jackson?
So brutal. All right, Joey.
What do we got here? Number what?
Seven.
So this is a pretty, you know, staple for Paul, but it's one that I can't leave off my list. My favorite song off his solo album. I know it's the common song, but I got to go with Tonight You Belong to Me. It's just the perfect Paul song. Everything about it, the way it starts, beautiful, heavy, emotional. It's the perfect Paul song.
Agree.
Yep.
I agree. You know, if we asked 100 people to pick a set list, you know, more than half of them would put that song in there. It was probably up higher into the 80 percentile. Because everybody remembers the first time they heard that song, because it's so like, it's like I Want You. It's very chill at the beginning, and then all of a sudden Mike Tyson punches you in the face and you get this kick ass.
Absolutely. You know, and on his solo jam. Tour too. Again, the reason why I always put Ace's album above Paul's album, not only because I like the songs a little bit better, but the production on Paul's album is very flat. The drumming is very flat performance-wise and production-wise. And even the guitar tones on that record are not great. Ace's album punches you in the face right from the get-go. But Paul's solo tour, when he did Tonight You Belong to Me with Eric Singer on drums and stuff, it was so, so strong and powerful live. It made me fall in love with that whole... I was never a big Paul Stanley solo record fan until I saw the solo tour in 89. And I went back and revisited everything because I fell in love with them all over again.
No, I get it. Lee?
Well, I went outside of the box this one. I was like, cool. I better force myself to pick something besides makeup. So I went to the Live to Win album because I really liked that. I went to the tour and it was really great. So I picked Bulletproof off the Live to Win.
I love that song.
I always liked that one. Yeah, like really rock. Yeah.
I love that whole record. It's
me
great.
Me too. So yeah, I had to pick one off of that.
Yeah. Of course I get crap because I love Asshole too. So
Whoa, that's a clip.
That's personal.
Pull that clip. That could be the start of every show.
All right. I will save that.
Perfect.
I mean, we're all here for you though. Whatever you like, Joel.
Oh my
That's
God.
The first time we ever said something on this show that could have been on Shout It Out Loudcast.
And I'm gonna go ahead and tell you. I'm gonna tell you this. Right after I said it, I got a warm rush over my body that I fucked up.
Here it comes.
And I'm not missing that one.
Oh, God. This is going to ruin me.
For that. Yeah.
Oh. Just so you know, I have a good sense of humor. And
he's so upset that he just said that. Look at him, Pooney. He's so upset at himself.
He
Look,
is.
Karen is calling his phone right now. Joe, you stupid asshole. What did you do?
It's okay. I don't care. It's whatever. It's whatever. Anything, get us more views. I don't give a shit. Okay. Sonny, just so you know, he loves asshole too.
Oh boy.
No. Not jeans anyway. Okay. So after we get done with Back on the Streets, Paul tries this thing. It doesn't work out too well. He's like pointing at people and says, you, not you, you. And people are wondering what the hell he's doing. And he's trying to get to you make me rock hard. That's what he's doing.
Nice. And they do you make me rock hard. Oh, nice. Disgusting and nice, Pony. I like it.
Very good.
I do want to point out that I believe that that's not the first time I said I love asshole on this show.
That is not. I have it clipped at other points.
I want to go ahead and tell you guys that I've said that 100 times because it makes Sonny mad. Let's see. What is this, 7? My number 7 is going to be Sword and Stone.
Ooh.
I would love to hear Paul Stanley sing that song.
Yeah.
Yeah. You could go online and you can hear, you know, you can hear those. I guess it's just unreleased, right?
No, it's on the Shocker soundtrack.
It's on the Shocker. Yeah. That's right.
Oh, officially on that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I have it. I bought the Shocker soundtrack because of that one song.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Yep.
I don't know amazing. If I ever knew that.
Okay, so next is
number 8, right?
Number 8, yes.
Yep.
I got to go with one of my favorite records, Unmasked. Never gets talked about. I mean, I know we talk about it cuz you know, we're Kiss nerds, but nobody knows anything on Unmasked if you're not a Kiss nerd like us. Tomorrow is such a great song on that record. Again, if you pump up that production a little bit and you beef it up and you throw it into the Animalize record or something with a little thicker production, It what a song. The whole Unmasked record is just, it's pop hit after pop hit. Whether you like pop or not, you can't deny. I know it came out at the same time as what Van Halen 2 and all this shit, but I know it doesn't compare sonically and power to stuff like that. But songwriting wise, they're on top of their game right here.
Agree.
Yeah, Brad's right. I forgot the Sword and Stone that's on Shocker is Bonfire doing it. It's not Paul doing it. I have Paul doing it, but I don't remember where I got it from.
I know the Paul demo. I have the demo where Paul does it, but there's no way the Kiss maniac that I was in the 80s, there's no way I there was a Kiss release that I didn't know about.
Yeah.
Right. Who's next?
Lee.
Me, Lee. Number 8. Let's see. My list is getting weird here. Let's see. Oh, number 8, I have Sure Know Something.
Good song. I love that you brought it down a little bit, you know?
Yeah, we have to go high to low.
That bass line is cool, too.
Very.
Wait, cool. I didn't hear. What was it?
Sure Know Something.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I love that bass line.
Sonny?
So, Joey, if you would have done Tomorrow at 7 and Tonight You Belong to Me at 8, you could have done Tomorrow and Tonight next.
Nice.
But you missed that. I'm not. I didn't pick that. But I'm just saying you missed that.
I didn't love my next one. Tomorrow and Tonight.
My next one, people love it. People hate it more than My Way. But I love Radar for Love. I absolutely love that song.
I like that one.
Why does that one get shit on too?
Oh, all the time. It's a Zeppelin knockoff. Blah blah blah. It's like whatever, dude.
What?
Yeah, but if you listen to it, it's got the cadence of.
Black Dog, right?
Yeah, it's got the cadence of Black Dog.
Yeah, Black Dog, but that's every blues song ever, Black Dog.
Yeah, but if you put
it's a
no, it's true, but I mean, they're
that's going to be a YouTube hit right there.
Oh,
yes, I'm cutting that one out.
We're live, Joe. You can't cut it out.
It'll be I'm not cutting it out. I'm going to edit it out and because it's a bumper now. Joey Quesada. La, da, 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 da. All right. My number, this is 7, right?
8.
My number 8 is Paul's favorite song, Love Gun.
The old standby.
Yep. Yes. Gotta have Love Gun in the set, I think. And it's just, It goes. It's classic. Love Gun was my favorite song for a long time until I saw Kiss so many times that I'm like, God bless, I'm so tired of this song.
Yeah, come out to see you.
Yeah. Yeah, so Love Gun's my number ocho. Nueve, Joey. Yeah,
Lee, I think what you just said, Love Gun was always my, probably always my favorite Kiss song as well. Paul doing that every time now. I'm going to come out to see you.
Come out to see you.
It annoys me so much now.
I think it's the best.
It almost disrupts Love Gun, my love of Love Gun, too.
Come on. It's funny.
Now every time that I'm with somebody seeing them live, I'm like, nah, stay. No, stay.
We don't want you to come out, Paul.
Send someone else out, please.
Right, yeah. Put jeans on there. Yeah. It would be something.
Hey, Jared, your question here. Which podcast did they mention the deep dive into Who's Sam? It's the Kiss Room. Go listen to that.
No. Shout it out loudcast.
Just type in.
Shout it out loudcast.
Don't be putting Matt Jared. Under the bus.
Jared, I'm not putting Matt under a bus. I want people to go listen to his show. Matt's new show is out. Go listen to Matt's show.
We love it's Matt.
Just, shout Jared, it out loudcast.
Jared, just type in two morons from Boston. It'll come right up. All right, so where are we? Number nine?
Number nine, Joey.
Nueve.
Oh, nine.
Again, I go back to Creatures. It's a staple for me. And again, especially if I'm the drummer in this band, Poonie, which I'll tell you my band in a few minutes. One of my favorite songs to play of all time, I Still Love You. It's so powerful. Even though I love the way Eric Carr played it on Creatures, the unplugged version, I just did it for Creatures Fest, is so, it's just a different type of song. It's a more pocket song. It's a groovier song. The one on Creatures is a little more in your face, but it's such a strong song.
It is.
It is.
Oh, and personal, just like
very
we always
emotional.
Say.
Yes.
Yeah, I can't remember who's it about again.
I think Dan Aykroyd, right?
No, I think it's about the girl that he's.
Oh, that's with. Right. Yes, yeah, right.
They're getting divorced right now, so Paul's got a shot. Under the bus.
I just got declined. I was trying to join Kiss Army's Revenge. I don't even know what that is. I don't even know when I requested to join it. I just got declined. So if you're a member of the Kiss Army Revenge on Facebook, why am I declined?
Hey, wow.
I just declined.
Oh, you suck.
I'm kidding. I wish I could.
As soon as Sonny said something, I knew he was going there. And I was like, that is awesome. That is awesome. All right.
Let's
so,
decline him live.
Decline.
Yeah. Deny.
Lee, you're up, right? This is 10.
Deny.
Yeah, number nine.
So, yeah, Lee. So I'm
I never
going,
know where we're at.
I'm going to Unmasked also with Easy As It Seems.
Yeah.
I just like that one.
You know, when I get done today, I'm going to go listen to some Kiss.
Is that something different?
No, that's the point.
My number nine, I didn't go to Creatures or Unmasked, but I came close. I went to Killers instead. Going to go with Nowhere to Run.
Dang, I was going to pick a Killers song, and I said, somebody else is going to pick both these songs. I'm going to go away from it, so I did. That's okay. That's a great...
That's not the one I would pick, but Killers is great, too. Those four songs are really good.
Yeah. And I'm telling you right now, you got to get every version because there's so many different versions of that record. And if you put the Japanese version on, there's stuff from The Elder on it. You put the Australian version on, there's stuff. Okay. Unmasked stuff. Anyway, okay.
I hope someone picked Just the Boy.
There are different mixes of those songs I've heard. I've heard like mixes of those four songs that sound more like Creatures of the Night mixes.
Where they're
yeah, they're really cool. They're heavier. They're just more bombastic.
Yeah, let's get those. Podcast Rock City 1, that's the number one, at gmail.com. You can send those to us, and I'll make sure to get them to Joey and everybody else.
Hey, what is this low light person saying over here? What is this? I didn't say low life. I said low light.
Yeah, low light. Kiss Army Revenge doesn't accept beautiful VO5 treated hair. Sorry.
Son of a bitch.
Wow.
Low life is at the dollar store. That's the only reason he uses it.
No, I don't use the shampoo, stupid. I use the beautiful hot oil treatment. It's very nice.
Who's next? Sonny, you're next. Tell a story.
No, I go. Wait, who goes next?
Joe, it's yours, number nine.
My number nine? Oh, okay, my bad. Tonight you belong to me, of course.
Of course.
I'm sorry. I'm lost, man. I don't know what's going on. Every time we've been doing these for 9 years, I always get lost.
The reason I started writing these down is I dealt with this every damn show. So for the first couple of shows, I'm like, somebody's got to write this shit down. And it wasn't going to be Joe and Jody because they couldn't remember what they just said. So I started writing it down.
There's over an 83% chance Jody can't even write.
That's a good point. Oh, we missed Jody. All right, Joey, you're next.
Number 10. I can't believe nobody picked this yet. I figured someone would have gobbled it up early. I got to go Mr. Speed. Again, it's a song that, you know, the Kiss fan base loves and you never hear it. I'd love to hear Paul do it. I'm surprised he didn't do it on his solo tour.
It was on my list and I cut it for another song. So, Lee?
My number 10 is Take Me.
Me.
Take Me. Nice. I think someone already said Take Me, but.
I did.
Yeah.
Great song.
We should have did this draft style. That way we really would have been stuck.
Have we done this before? Not have we done that? Style. No, have we ever done anything draft style?
Not really. We did that draft live. I did a live draft at a convention once, but that was it.
Joey and I were on a wrestling show one time, and we did a draft. Remember, Joey?
I do remember that.
And what was the topic again? It was pick your
for all the champions.
It was the champions for
Mount Rushmore or something.
No. It was the champions for your, like, if you had a wrestling organization. And I'll tell you, hands down, Joey and Joe's lists blew those fuckers away. The guys that host the show didn't know shit about wrestling. We blew them away.
Oh, they were mopes.
Okay, All right. What's next?
My number 10 is right before the encore, and he finishes off the regular set with It's All Right. Got to go back to the solo album.
It's all right. Yeah. I sang. You're welcome. So, Lee. All right, Lee. Keep it going. Hey, Lee, did you play a gig last night?
Friday.
You played a gig Friday? Damn, I saw it.
I only played like a half a set because my arms are shit.
Wait, Sinzak is yelling at one of you. Who said at a convention?
Okay, I don't know.
I didn't remember if it was at a convention. Sorry, it was at Rockin' Pod.
Chris, he's a moron. See, he can't even... I would always see that. I pulled your comment to the front there. Put it back up, Joe. What are you doing?
Okay, my bad.
I want to make sure everyone knows about Rockin' Pod and Sinzak. Sonny will not do anything for you, Chris. I'm in your corner. Don't worry.
Hashtag no respect.
Yes, and there will and there.
Ask Joey if he's ever been to a Rockin' Pod. That would be a big fat.
What's Rockin' Pod again?
No.
This moron Sinzak always it's my every year he does it. It's on my son's birthday. I can't ever go.
Well, he's doing it again, and I don't know the date yet. I know that they announced the date. Chris just put it up so I can tell everybody. And the special guest this year, and the guest of honor is going to be us. We're going to be the main people that they care about. Just kidding. Chris always puts me in a corner like baby. I'm just kidding.
Joe in the corner.
I'm just kidding. He loves us. Let's see. Okay. I don't know where we're at. Sonny. No,
Joe, we're at your number 10.
My number 10.
Joe, we're at your number 10.
Wait, Joe or Joey?
Oh, Rocket.
Joe, we're at your number 10.
If it's mid-March, I could do it, buddy. If you want me still, but we'll leave Sonny home.
No, Sonny's got to come. It's fun to see everybody. And Lee can come, too. It'll be awesome. Lee,
I'd love to see Lee.
If you guys have never heard our interviews, Chris gets us the best interviews for that thing. This past Rockin' Pod, I got to interview Matt Pinfield, one of Joey's friends from that metal show. What's his name?
Don Jameson?
Yeah. Oh. I had a couple of the guys from Ace's band. It was a lot of fun. I was supposed to have other people, but it got complicated. So, but I was very happy, and that's all I got to say about that.
Hold on. I might be back in for Kiss Army Revenge, baby. Someone just messaged me. Hey, man, try again in about 10 or 15 minutes. Kiss Army Revenge. I told him you were good. You better believe it.
Wow. You're real picky about who gets in.
Yeah, that's awesome. So now everybody go to Kiss Army Revenge and flood that motherfucker so he's got to sit there going, what the hell is going on?
Oh,
I'm doing it.
They just booted me.
What the hell?
Are you serious?
I'm kidding.
Oh, I can't.
Okay.
I got to look it up now. Is it on Facebook?
Yes. Yeah, okay, Facebook. Yeah. All right. My number 10 is going to be Exciter.
Yeah.
Nice. Nobody's picked that one yet, right?
I don't think so.
Not yet.
Yeah, I love that song. Exciter is my number DS. Nice. Sunny.
It's not Sunny, it's Joey.
Joey.
What are we doing? Number 11. Yeah, right. So these are my encores as well. These are going to be two staples, but I cannot leave them off this set list. I got to go. To me, it's just a great way to start the encore. I Want You, the way it starts. They did it on the Rock the Nation tour when I toured with them. It's such a good song. I forget how great it is. It's never a song I go to put on. I never put Rock and Roll Over on and put that on right away. But every time I hear it, I'm like, holy shit, I forgot how great this song is.
Yes. Agreed.
Okay, look, this. I was reading comments and I totally missed your song. What was the song?
Want You.
Oh, I Want You. Okay.
I'm
sorry, I'm reading
the comments. The comments are on the same pages where you're looking. How could you not read a comment and listen to me at the same time?
Look, Heavy Mayo's with me. What'd I miss?
Heavy Mayo, you son of a bitch. You heard me, didn't you?
I think he just got here.
No, he's listening all the way.
I know, but I hadn't seen him in there earlier. Okay, it doesn't matter.
There's no better name. I say it every week. There's no better name than Heavy Mayo.
Yes.
I mean, come on.
Yeah. Hey, Lee, you're next. Number 11.
I think you've all said this one already, but Tonight You Belong to Me was my number 11.
It has to be.
Yeah,
has
it has to
be
on the
list.
It has to be. I mean.
Yeah. Sonny.
So my two encores, I'm going to say one now. The reason they're the encores is John 5 is a smart guy. When he knew he was going to get the gig, he told Paul, I'll give you a 25% discount if I get to pick the last two songs on the set list. Mm. And Paul tells the crowd this.
Okay.
And they go into Mr. Speed.
Oh, nice.
Sweet.
I'm glad I took it first.
It's such a good song, though. It's such a good song. Now that song is on a soundtrack. Anybody know which one?
No.
Debbie Does Dallas 3, The Final Chapter.
I was gonna Pooty beat me too. I was gonna say some porn.
Mr. Speed is on the Speed with Keanu Reeves
no,
soundtrack.
It is
the original Speed.
It is not.
You're lying.
It is not.
I'm gonna write it in a Wikipedia page and make it real.
Yeah. That is not.
Okay. They should have, but it's not.
My number 11 is going to be Making Love.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Yeah, I kick ass from here. The last two songs are kick ass, and that's all I got to say about that.
That's all I got.
All right, Joey, last song.
Yeah, I got to close the night out. I know it's boring because we've all heard it a gazillion times, but... How are you going to have a set without Love Gun in it? You just can't. I'm not letting Paul come out to the audience. I'll cut the cable first. Let him stay on stage with us. My band, I got to put myself on drums. I'd love to do it. I did get to play Love Gun with Paul once. It was incredible. I put my boy Steve Brown on guitar. One of the most underrated guitar players ever. I play with him. He's in Trickster, obviously. We play with Eric Martin together. We did the Unplugged set at Creatures Fest. And as for bass, really, bass doesn't matter. It's a bass player. I pick anyone. I'm kidding. I'm teasing. Anyone.
Let's talk to Steve Harris about that.
I will take anyone but PJ Farley. Anyone but PJ from Quarantine. Please send in your audition tapes to sunnypoony at prc.com.
That's brutal.
That was brutal.
I gotta close with Love Gun. I just have to do it. Jesus. I was almost going to leave it off, but I can't.
Couldn't. I agree.
Let's see. Lee is next. Yes.
Me. I did leave Love Gun off just because I knew everybody else would pick it. So I'm closing it out with I Stole Your Love.
Yeah.
Awesome. Sonny.
I left Love Gun off, and I'm closing off with Exciter. So nice. Opened with I've Had Enough, closing with Exciter.
Okay.
Not bad. What was my last song? Come On and Love Me?
Make it love.
Come On and Love Me is my last one. And before we move on, I want to read something to you guys. Speed, the original motion picture soundtrack, listing the songs. Speed by Billy Idol. A Million Miles Away by some band Plimsolls. Soul Deep, Gin Blossoms, Let's Go for a Ride, Cracker, Go Outside and Drive, Blues Traveler, Crash, Rick Ocasek, rest in peace, my brother. I love that guy. Let's see. Rescue Me by Pat Benatar. Hard Road by Rod Stewart. COT, Cot, I don't know what that is, by Carnival Strippers. Cars, 93 Sprint by Gary Newman. Like a Motorway, Saint something. And number 12 is Mr. Speed by Kiss. Thank you very much.
I didn't know this.
It's an absolute lie. He made it up.
No, I just clicked on it, and now we could go ahead and get in trouble. Oh, no, it won't play because it's connected to my headphones. Google it yourself. It's on there. And I knew it was on there because I looked at it and never bought it, but I should have. But it's on the soundtrack.
Okay.
It is. Wow, it's even on Apple Music.
Nobody believes me. I had no idea. I'm going to point out that the guy that doesn't know anything knew that. Thank you very much.
I do have to agree. You don't know anything, Joe.
And I do have to agree that knowing this is fucking sad.
Yes, it's terrible. I have so many records over there with just one Kiss song on them, all those K-Tel every K-Tel record. I don't have the Speed one. Okay, so this was a lot of fun. We went a little over our regular hour. But, yeah, of course, it's always awesome to, yeah, look, see there, Loving Off the Grid says Mr. Speed was the final song on the movie soundtrack. Thank you guys for watching and listening. Don't forget, like our page, subscribe to our YouTube page, and go to clicktees.com and order a Podcast Rock City shirt. And even if you don't, order a Kiss shirt or a Kiss kind of shirt. If you see them, if you've never been there, you'll get what I mean by when I say kind of. Like and share the show if you can. If you've got friends that have never heard us, and you know, let them know about our show, and we appreciate it. 40 people hung out with us for this entire show. Thank you very much. Sonny, do you have anything to add?
No, thanks for listening. And the Kiss Cruise voting is out there. So if you go to the website, you can vote. And I will tell you, at the LA Maybe, the Fifth, and Sisters Doll is on that list. They probably deserve some votes because there's some great bands. So,
absolutely. Also, next week, we're going to talk a little bit about Cruise Fest coming up. If you guys have not, if you're going on the cruise and you haven't looked at that yet, I recommend it. They're going to have Slaughter's going to be there, and a few other really awesome bands. Return of the Comet, I believe, is going to be there, which is the Fraley's Comet. And I'm sorry, his name just... The drummer from Fraley's Comet.
Anton Figg?
Is going to be there.
Wow.
He knows Mr. Speed is on the Speed soundtrack. He doesn't know who Anton Figg is.
Listen, I'm going to tell you...
Unbelievable.
I do not pretend to be Julian Gill. He knows everything. Read his books. He has, if you ask Julian Gill, like I read Julian. Okay. So this is my nod to the Kiss FAQ show. If you guys, he said in his book, something about the elder, I I've listened to The Elder 6,000 times before I ever read this part in the book. I read what he says. I'm like, no fucking way that this is true. I put on the album, and in the background, at the beginning of the song, the first song, you can hear a train horn. Because it was going by where they were recording it, and they didn't catch it, I guess. So everybody go ahead, put on the beginning of The Elder, and just listen for a train. As soon as Julian wrote that, he ruined that fucking record for me. I'm just kidding. It didn't ruin it. It made it amazing. It's like, damn. I don't know if he noticed it or if somebody else did, but there is a train horn, which obviously was not meant to be on the record, considering it's supposed to be like medieval, right? But it is. Sonny, doesn't
that make
it
supposed to be on the record? It was supposed to be on the record. They just clipped out the wreck part. Straight up train wreck right before the album starts.
And that's why we love him, everybody. Okay.
And it ends at the end with a dumpster fire. Just light it up.
I agree. That I song, I hate that song. And I saw them play it live, and I popped like a kid seeing Goldberg come out after he won the title. they played Rock and Roll All Night, and then they went into I, and you'd have thought I saw boobs for the first time. I was so, oh my god, look at these boobs. And I sang every word, and I don't like that song anyway. Sonny, you did yours. Lee, what do you have to add? Anything?
This was a lot of fun. I am pissed that nobody picked Just a Boy for their list. It's okay.
Including you.
I
actually do like that song. I do.
The Elder. I can't help myself. As a kid, I did not like it when it came out. I was like, what the hell? But as an adult, I love it.
This is why you go on the cruises, because I'll tell you, on the very first Kiss cruise, Paul sang a little bit of Just a Boy. And it was crazy.
And wasn't someone dressed as the Elder Door?
No.
Yes, they were on the cruise.
No, there was, but it's, God. Yeah, it was awesome.
Dressed as the Door from the Elder.
Yeah, it was awesome. Joey, you have a big announcement for next week. Where are you going to be?
A couple little things. First, definitely vote for my boys and sisters, Doll. Great guys, killer musicians. Vote for them to be on the Kiss Cruise. They absolutely deserve it. Sam Loomis, you goofy fuck. Please reach out to us. Come on. Talk. We want to talk about why you did what you did, who you are. You can even come on and not show your video. Just talk and disguise your voice. Disguise your voice like in those old hostage videos and stuff. Whatever you want to do. Come on. Tell us why you did what you did. I don't even care. You want to release more videos? I honestly don't give a shit. I love the drama. Come on and tell us what's going on. I want to stir the pot.
Yes.
Also, yeah.
Love me some drama.
Yes, Joe.
No, go ahead.
And so the news that I have is ZO2 is reuniting next week. We're opening up for Stone Temple Pilots, King's X, and Steven Adler from Guns N' Roses up in Peekskill, New York. We have a guest bass player filling in for the sadly departed David Z. Sean McNabb is going to be on bass. It's going to be a great, great show. There's still some tickets available. It will sell out if you guys are thinking about coming. Peekskill, New York. It's at the Paramount Theater. It's going to be a great, great show. My students from School of Rock are actually opening the show, and then ZO2 goes on. It's going to be an early day. We're going to start the music around 4 p.m. and go throughout the night. Come early if you get tickets. You can get the tickets. Go to my Facebook page, and you'll see the link. Come out and support. It'll be a fun night.
Absolutely. And Joey, what did you say? What date did you say that was?
July 30th, a week from the next Saturday.
Next Saturday. Okay, cool. This was a lot of fun. I really enjoy doing these things with you guys because I get to pick your brains and hear what you guys think and what you guys love. And it's amazing for the listener to be able to go and send us their own lists. I have a few and I want to read them to you guys. So let's see here. I got this one just a little bit ago. And of course now it's disappeared. Hold on. I got it.
Wait till we do Peter. Let me read the list. Oh, okay. Boy. List number one, Baby Driver.
Stop.
List number two.
Blah, 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 blah.
Okay, so Randy Miller, thank you. I'm going to read his today, and then I'll add more next week because I've got a bunch of them. Randy Miller sent live solo records, Ace, Rip It Out, Outer Space, Dancing with Danger, Hard Times, Insane, Shock Me with the solo, Trouble Walking, Speeding Back to My Baby, Parasite, We Got Your Rock, Cold Gin, and Torpedo Girl. The Gene is Hate, Love's a Deadly Weapon, She, Killer, Burning Up with Fever, Watching You, Paralyzed, Here Comes the Sun by the Beatles.
Wow.
Friday on My Mind, The Easy Beats, Calling Dr. Love, and Domino. And then his Paul one, which is the last one we've done, is I Stole Your Love, Mr. Speed, Come On and Love Me, Where Eagles Dare, All American Man, Bulletproof, Tonight You Belong to Me, Take Me, Keep Me Coming, Nowhere to Run, The Oath, and Goodbye. And there were a couple the Live Oath. To Win.
Oh, I forgot The Oath. Jesus.
Wow. The Oath.
Yeah. So you know what I'm going to say. Listen, every week there are a lot of podcasts, KISS podcasts that get out there. When you're sitting around, instead of if you're the type of person that listens to anything else, especially if it's a politics slop, turn that shit off and go and support these people because they work really hard at this for you guys. And the cool thing is it's rare that the main topic, the news is the news, you know, but the main topic is usually not going to be the same through all the shows. All week long, you could get a cool KISS topic. If you're a diehard fan like we are, you could get a cool KISS topic and go back in their catalogs and listen too. You can always find some of these shows have 200, 300 shows. And then, you know, support them. Whatever they're doing, they love KISS. We don't know how long they're going to keep doing this. They're, you know, so do your best to get out there and find them and listen. But start with Podcast Rock City every week. You know what I'm going to say. We love podcasts and we love KISS podcasts. Most of them anyway. You guys can love all the ones you want. We're not going to. And you're going to hear all the commercials for that. And that includes the KISS Room. Make sure the KISS Room's new show is up right now, and I put it personally on kissasylum.com. Go click on it and listen to it, and you're going to hear the commercials for even that show right after this. I'm tired of talking now, and I know everybody's tired of hearing me. In 3, 2, 1, peace.